Welcome back to another episode of Rob Bill. We got the red lights to signify blood and bloodshed because that perfectly encapsulates and when hits the fan, I put it all out there for y'all to hear. And hopefully there is a learning mistake or a lesson that you'll take away from today's video. The tale of the four thieving bandit bears that broke into my chalet. Okay, so let's get into it. You know, my favorite thing is when I go to bed and then I sleep and then I wake up to like a full of messages from a guest. Wake up at 7:30 and I get this exact message from a guest. I'm just gonna read you the highlights here. Jamie says, "Good morning. We're really enjoying the cabin, but we have a serious bear problem. The day we got here, we were unloading the car and the back was open as we got a couple of loads up and took a minute to check the place out. We looked off the upper deck and there was a bear in the car. We took video, thought it was a little freaky, but wasn't too worried about it. They didn't damage anything. They just rummaged through and grabbed our road snacks and wandered off." Isn't that cute? You know, imagine going to the Smoky Mountains and you're like grocery shopping and you're like, "Oh my God, there's a bear just riding shotgun in my vehicle." You know, honestly, this is not the first time this has happened. One time when I was setting up the place, we made the mistake of dumping all of our trash in the back of a truck bed, came out and there was a bear there and we had to like run out and like, I think someone shot a gun. It's like a murder mystery. Like what? I don't remember. Someone did shoot a gun. All right, let's just hit pause. We're gonna go back to this story in a second because I actually have another good bear story that happened at the same chalet. You've heard about the story when the bear walked up to me and was 5 feet away, right? But what you didn't hear was about that same day when we were all inside of the chalet and we hear screams outside and it's like, "Help! Help! I'm dying!" Okay, they didn't say that, but they were like, "Help! Help!" One of the guys that I was traveling with, he just always travels with a gun. He says anytime he leaves his house on a vacation, he goes with a gun. Is this the thing?
Why would I know?
I don't know, you seem like the kind of guy that might do that. Anyways, he always travels with a gun. I feel like you gotta tell people, you know?
Come with me if you want to live.
Anyways, someone's outside. They're screaming. They're like, "Help! Help me!" We all run outside. We're like, "Oh my God, something is happening." He goes, he grabs his gun, and then he runs and he beelines it for the neighbor's house. And then all of a sudden, we hear a gunshot. We're like, "Oh, stuff is getting real, okay?" He walks back and we're like, "What the heck just happened?" Turns out that the neighbors had just gotten home grocery shopping. Okay, it was a dad and a son. And the son sees the bear and runs into the car. And I don't think he tells his dad. And so the dad is like, has no idea where his son is at. He thinks his son went into the house and he runs for the patio. And he's like, "Let me in! Let me into the house!" Because he's on the patio and there's a bear that has cornered him on the patio. So he's like, "Help! Help!" Freaking out. And this is all happening like literally within 30 seconds. That's how fast this entire story is. I'm milking it for YouTube. So basically, homeboy comes out with his gun. He shoots it. Bear gets super scared, turns around, runs away. Dad is like, goes and looks for his son, finds it. His son is like 14 or something. And he's like, "What the hell, man? Why did you let me in the house?" And the son is like, "I was in the car." He's like, "I almost got eaten by a bear, son. Thank you, by the way, for shooting the gun. It's weird that you had it, but thank goodness, I suppose." Honestly, moral of the story, had he not brought the gun, there is a strong chance that this bear would have mauled the dad. And because he shot it, the bear ran away and got scared. That's the quick sidebar on the bear story.
All right, so we're gonna hit pause on the whole Airbnb situation for a second. Yes, I lost my voice. Wanted to quickly say that I've launched a couple new cool things with the Host Camp program. So if you wanna learn more how to avoid bears and how to start your own Airbnb business, head over to hostcamp.com or click the link in my description down below. And also, you won't have to wait a month anymore for the call because I hired people. I did it. I'm doing it, guys. All right, now back to the bears because it's about to get good.
So let's get back to the original story and point of this entire video. Okay, bear just chilling shotgun, riding shoddy in the car, in their car because they left the hatch open. Then they say, no big deal, they didn't damage anything. Bear adventure to talk about. But then yesterday, we came home for a couple of hours in Gatlinburg and my son was bringing in some things from the car, headed to the sliders and they were open. We went up to the front door, opened it up and the place was a mess. There had been four bears in the cabin. They ate almost all of the food we had just bought the night before. Thankfully, they didn't do much damage. They did break one white vase on the dining table. They knocked a couple of lamps over, but nothing broke. But we know there had been four in the cabin because they were still here. They were playing in the woods and came back once we were in the cabin. A mom and three cubs. That's kind of adorable though. You come home and like little baby bears are frolicking in the yard and you're like, "Hey, you ate all my Doritos, man. What the hell? I wish I had brought a gun with me." Oh, they were completely unafraid of us yelling, banging, sounding the car alarm. They played in the yard for a while before Mama Bear gathered the cubs and wandered off. You know why they were unafraid, Caleb? You know why? Because they didn't have a gun. Okay, she says, we live in Michigan and we have bears there too, but they're not adapted to people. So we're not as freaked out about the bear issue as much as some other people may be, but it's a little concerning because it's a mama and cubs and they hang out in here. I like to think that they were like in there trying on their clothes and like playing house and stuff, and they're like, oh, it's time to go, they're here. Don't leave the Doritos, man. You know, just leave it. It's fine. Come on, let's go. And he's like, grr, grr, it's so good. That's obviously the noise that a bear makes.
That was bad.
We're working on the Chewbacca. And now they have been there twice and I'm not sure when they will be back. So I'm not sure what to do with the situation. I tend to underreact to things, but this could be a dangerous situation for people. Sliders are very hard to close and they don't lock. May have been cracked open when we left. I feel like that's an important designation. They don't lock, so I'm not sure how to secure them when we leave again. I know nature isn't under your control. I used to own my own vacation rental company for 10 years, and I had people freaking out over bats and black flies. No, actually, I can feel that. But what do? We can make sure the sliders are closed, but we can't lock them. Misinformation. Before you start firing up the old thingies and you're like, well, you need to provide locks. There are locks. So I'm like, oh, this is a first. So I text my business partners. I'm like, check out the message that Jimmy just sent us. Four bears just broke into our cabin. So here's kind of like the tough love moment that I have with the guest. All right, so here's how I open it up because I think it's important to have a little bit of humor and, you know, provide a little levity in the situation. So I'm like, good morning. First of all, let me say that I'm glad everyone is okay. That's true, genuine. I don't want a lawsuit. That's important news, smiley face. Always have to have the smiley face, not an emoji, just the actual, like, you know, the colon parentheses. Secondly, it sounds like you've gotten the full Gatlinburg experience. Laughy sweat face, you know what I mean? I'm like, hey, well, but seriously, I totally understand how frightening that can be. I've actually had Mama Bear walk up to me before, provide a little bit of empathy, like, hey, been there. Actually, almost got attacked one time. And then I was like, but here's the deal. And here's what you have to understand, Jamie. You left your car open and your car was full of food. Then I hit Google and I'm like, how strong is a bear's sense of smell? 2100 times. And I was like, a bear, acting like I know this, like I'm trying to look like the local authority over here. I'm like, listen, bears, don't know if you know this, okay? I know this, I've been doing this for a while. They have a sense of smell that is 2100 times greater than that of a human. It's a little fact for you, okay? Don't expect you to know this off the top of your head, but me, Ranger Rob, been through this a time or two. Secondly, you did mention that you may have left the slider door open. Now, don't know if you know this, if you leave a slider door open that is accessible to a bear, they can just walk into the slider door. Just facts, all right? Not really groundbreaking revelations here. I just want you to know the door is open and there's food in the house. Remember that sense of smell I was telling you about? That kicks in, they'll go in and they'll eat all the food. Thirdly, there are locks on the door. There's a latch that latches it. And there's also a wooden dowel that you can put on the slider so that it doesn't open. Can you just check? I'm like, if that's not true, let me know. I'm gonna send a handyman out there as soon as possible because genuinely, I wanna get this fixed. Don't hear back from her. And I'm like, well, this is, you know, I hope I hear back from her. Usually I would call, but I don't remember. I think I was watching the kids that weekend. I don't really remember. But basically I never hear back. She checks out. Literally, the moment she checks out, she leaves us a review. And the way it works on Airbnb is you cannot see that review until you write a review. And I was like, Papa Bear has got to do some recon and just find out how the guest is feeling. So I call her and I'm like, listen, how's it going? I'm so sorry about everything. I never heard back from you. Are you guys alive? And she's like, oh my God, yeah, okay. So yeah, talk to my son. He left the slider open. I did check. There were latches to lock the slider. We did find the wooden dowel. Basically, they were like, it's our fault and I'm sorry. And I was like, okay, but other than that, was it still good? You know, like a 5-star experience? And she's like, oh my God, we loved it, blah, blah, blah. There are a couple little things like, you know, we were missing some silverware here and then. And I was like, great, I'll fix that. Thank you so much. And I did, right? So I actually took her feedback and I used it to make the listing better. So then I was like, all right. So I leave her a review and she leaves me a very long, beautiful, heartfelt 5-star review. Doesn't even mention the bears. I kind of wish she would have. I think it would have been a great review because we're very upfront with people and we say there is a sign. Okay, this is how upfront we are. There's like a sign when you walk in that says watch out for bears, ... literally. Like we don't play around. And I say in the listing, you will see bears. Do not leave open food in your car. They will break into your car. So anyways, moral of the story here is that homegirl left her car open. She left open the house. The bears got in and oh my God, like there was actually not any damage at all. And so I call my cleaner and I'm like, hey, is my cabin like okay? Like I heard heard bears broke in, and she's like, yeah, the bears are still here. And I was like, really? They're like just outside? She's like, yeah, they've been here since we got here. And I'm like, my cleaner, she's like 65, 70. And I'm like, you just walking up to the chalet? Like, you're not scared? You just walk up? She's like, yeah. Good for you, because I ran like a little baby. So what are the lessons to be learned here? Well, so we used to have bear mace. We actually recommend against that now. You're more than likely gonna hurt yourself more than the actual bear itself, or you'll make the bear mad and hurt yourself and get attacked, and it's not a good story. So I think what I'm gonna start leaving is a gun. I'm just kidding. A foghorn, an air horn, then near, near, near. Like one of those. That way they can just, you can like walk around with that, feel safe, scare a bear off if you're in that situation. And that, my friends, I don't know, did that kind of fizzle out? And then they all die. Just kidding. If you want to learn more about the customer service aspect of bears and how to deal with them in your Airbnb and how to provide excellent customer service to your guests when all this happens, consider enrolling in Host Camp, my 12-month mentorship program. We teach you how to find deals, analyze deals, how to run and operate short-term rentals, how to design them, how to automate them, and everything in between. I give you my entire blueprint from A to Z, and when you create a listing, you can be amongst the hundreds of listings across the world that all of my students have launched in the last year. So book a free call with my team over at hostcamp.com, or you can click the link in the description down below. Okay, that's it. Nobody actually died, but it was fun, right? This was fun. Should I do more of these? All right, we'll see. See you.